Right.
Okay.
Σήμερα με ιδιαίτερη χαρά έχουμε κοντά μας τον κύριο Στίβεν Μπέρεστι, τον άνθρωπο που πίστεψε στο όνειρό του από την αρχή. Μία ιδέα την οποία υποστηρίζει με πάθος κάθε μέρα που περνάει. Ποια είναι αυτή η ιδέα? Ας αφήσουμε τον ίδιο να τη μοιραστεί μαζί μας. Mr. Μπέρεστι, first of all, I would like to thank you for being here with us today. I know that just a few hours from now, you will have finished your first six-day film seminar you were running here in Cyprus. Okay, although, allow me to take things from the beginning. Would you like to tell us about your vision? What is your dream about that?
Well, I would like to think it's only my vision, but a vision shared between me and many of my Greek friends, including the vice governor and governor of the Kypriotis, but then Greek American friends like George Papadopoulos, Pierre Kamalopoulos. We all collectively would like to see Cyrus become a production center for international filmmakers. We would like to see a studio built here that provides facilities that are among the best in the world. We would like to provide an education to international students, but more importantly, to Greek students and working professionals that will allow them to compete on a level playing field with filmmaking centers all around the world. And that, I guess, is our shared vision of what we see in the future.
Okay, that's very important. So, how did the whole idea begin? I mean, I know that you've been here in Greece a lot of times as a child. So, was this idea something that you were thinking about for a long time, or you would probably describe it as a conjecture?
Yeah, a conjecture or an accident, a happy accident.
Okay.
I was in Mykonos with my friend George Papadopoulos. We were working on a feature screenplay together, and called Liam. And we had lunch at a fantastic restaurant in Mykonos, and we met some friends who lived here in Cyprus. And the conversation turned, as it so often does with me, because it's my whole life, to film, and how films get made around the world, and particularly how they get made here. And I was surprised to learn, because I didn't know this, that Greece had no tax incentive in place, despite its rich and important film history. So I conjectured that it would be a good idea if they did have it. I also thought it would be a good idea if they had more people working in film, because in Los Angeles I often worked as a judge or a mentor at the LA Greek Film Festival, and I have many Greek American friends there who are Greek filmmakers, Greek American filmmakers. So I was surprised there wasn't more being done here. So they said, well look, these are great ideas, why don't you come to Cyrus and meet the deputy governor. I did. I spoke to him. I presented my ideas. He presented to me his ideas, which were along many of the same lines. And weeks later, I went back to Los Angeles, where I live, wrote a proposal. He looked at it, modified it, adjusted it, and presented it to the central government, who also expressed an interest. And then suddenly events just overtook us, and we found that on August the 3rd of this past year, the tax incentive was approved. And then, as you rightly say, this past week has been a six-day intensive film training program for everyone who was interested. And we thought, when we offered this, 10 students, 20 students, we would have been very happy with that. We weren't quite prepared for the over 400 applicants we got for the place that we had in the course, and finally settled on.
Okay, that's very interesting. So, as you know, many people think that there are a lot of difficulties that someone should overcome with related to this plan. So, what's your answer to all these people who may be afraid to believe in this idea?
I don't get it, I'm afraid, but I'm not from Greece.
Okay.
All I've met here so far is support, optimism, practical logistical guidance, people offering us their homes to stay in, people buying us meals, people giving us free advice, legal insight, generosity upon generosity, optimism upon optimism. I know there are rumors abound which are suggesting that somehow there's great difficulties. We haven't encountered anyone. We've had the government, the central government, been very helpful, the local government very helpful, people in Athens helpful, and people here in Syria helpful. So if there are obstacles, we haven't met them yet.
Okay, that's very important because it's the way we think. Now, I want to discuss something very important, as we said. We're so close to the end of the first of many training programs you will be running on this island. So, you talked to us about this seminar before. Okay, you were the person who taught in this film course. I was wondering if you want to share with us your first impressions. And what about the energy on all the interaction with the Greek audience?
I've had a great time. We, all of us, the people attending the course and myself, have really, I think, enjoyed speaking to each other about big concepts, not just concepts about film, but about life, about leadership, about all the creative arts and sciences that are applicable to film. We have a ways to go. This was a general introductory provide an overview of how film works, because I believe all education begins with the big overview, seeing the framework that everything subsequently has to be plugged into. But as a beginning, I thought it was a great one, and I've had such great pleasure teaching here, and I say the reception's been so very warm. You know, we do have a few small obstacles to overcome. If we're really going to build a studio here, we still have to eliminate the VAT, put us on a level playing field with countries in Europe and the rest of the world. But in terms of individual enthusiasm from the students and the participants, I can't remember having such a good time in a course in over 20 years of teaching.
Okay, that's wonderful. Now, what's the next big step? Also, many people who are interested in this film school may wonder how long from now it will be created.
So. Well, there we have, I think, a fairly major announcement. Our original intention was to do nothing until late next summer. But we have been so surprised and overwhelmed by the response that Carolyn Martin, my partner in this, and I have decided together that we're going to bring the next program forward. And in the end of April, beginning of May, we'll be offering our first three-week intensive program, which will include screenwriting, producing, and general production techniques. This time we'll have more time to enroll students. This time we'll have more time to bring in other international lecturers who are friends of mine, who also work professionally in the industry, and we're very excited about that opportunity and to be able to offer it so soon.
Okay, that will be the kind of seminar too. What about the film school? When do you plan that will be?
Well, that will be part of the film school. We'll be offering practical education at that time.
Okay.
Hands-on experience with cameras. We'll have a writer's boot camp where I'll sit down with screenwriters, have them begin a screenplay, and finish a screenplay within the context of the course. So everybody who signs up for the writer's boot camp will complete a feature screenplay. Everyone who signs up for production, course, will get practical production experience. And every producer will produce a budget, production plan, schedule, all that other thing a producer is obliged to teach. The film school begins in earnest, well really it began last week, but it begins in earnest in the traditional sense in the middle of April and beginning of May.
Sounds great. Okay. In general now, you have such a big experience in filmmaking. In your opinion, what are the elements that make a place ideal for the production of international movies.
What makes a series ideal for the production of international movies are a variety of things. First, enviable weather. Most of the time, the weather in Cirrus is spectacular and it's beautiful.
Yes.
The physical beauty, very important. There's few places on Earth, in fact, I would conjecture, there's no place on Earth as beautiful as Greece. Physical infrastructure. We need a place that has an airport. Cirrus has an airport. We bring heavy equipment to a film set when we're doing big films. Cirrus has got a great big port with lots of opportunity to land large ships. We need locations that have a variety of different looks for both period and contemporary films. Cirrus is almost unique in the opportunity it presents to us in this regard. It has Italian buildings from the 19th and 18th century. It's got contemporary buildings. It's got a variety of architectures. And it's got a city. We need all the support for those international film schools that a city provides. We need shops. We need medical attention. There's a great hospital here that's first rate and it's right on the island. So it's like Cirrus was designed as a place to make films. I can't think of any place anywhere that's ideal as Cirrus.
Yes, it's a combination of things. So that's the answer to many people's question, why Cirrus? Okay.
Yes.
One last question. I know your passion. I can see your deep love. The deep love you feel for the Greece and Greek people. In your opinion, what makes you feel that way?
There's so many things wonderful about Greece and Greek people. I go back to what has been a core to us since we've been here. People have been buying us meals, letting us stay in their homes, giving us free advice, embracing us as if part of their family. There's something that's still in Greek culture that's been lost in other places of the world to do with the warmth and an understanding of those things which bind us together. And that sense is magical. You're also highly intellectual people. People skilled and have an understanding of the arts. And a great generosity towards other human beings and a desire to do things that are good and worthwhile. For all the supposed pessimism that people told me I would encounter here, I've encountered but nothing but really optimism and forward thinking. It's a place I love and a place I remember.
Okay, we're so happy for all these amazing announcements we have created. Okay, Mr. Branson, it is everything come true and a future full of grace.